Hi, I'm out here today with Denny Lawrence, Crop Protection FSR. We're out here looking and assessing some soybean fields for volunteer corn. So Denny, in my area, I'm kind of on that fringe acres from the derecho from last year, and then further north I have some acres where they really were affected by some strong winds in the fall. And so I just wanted to get a good game plan because we need to figure out what to do for this volunteer corn out here.
Sure. So, with the derecho, there's some pretty severe volunteer corn situations. So the one thing that I like to point out in this situation is we're going to have to manage and not just spray, which means maybe some unpopular decisions like higher rates, potentially a second trip or maybe a trip only for volunteer corn, and then a cleanup trip later in a tank mix. The timing on some of these volunteer corn products may not be quite right for a tank mix versus, say, your broadleaf control. So you're gonna have to really assess each situation and evaluate what's the right way to manage it. But it does need managed, not just sprayed.
Let's take a look at some of this volunteer corn and see what we can come up with.
Sure. Okay, here's a situation that's fairly common with volunteer corn where it grows from an ear in the field versus individual kernels growing, and it gets pretty thick, as you see. So obviously when we spray this, we're going to have some coverage issues with some of these smaller ones that are down underneath here that may or may not get a lethal dose on them. So that's a situation where it may require a second application or potentially higher volumes of water or higher rates. But again, it's going to have to be managed separate from just spraying volunteer corn. I spoke with Jonathan Court this morning, who's a tech rep with Valent, about SelectMax in particular, and his base rate is a 9-ounce rate. Now, that's assuming you're spraying with maybe straight Liberty or straight Roundup. If we start tank mixing additional products, broadleaf compounds, there's a bit of antagonism, so we need to take rates up on the volunteer corn products. So an additional 3 ounces if you're throwing in maybe a Flexstar or a Extendamax, or in the case of Enlist beans, they want to bump that rate even higher. If you're using Warrant in addition, it takes a little bit more. So then we're up to about a 12-ounce rate for sure in tank mixes with Warrant. So make sure we get the rates high enough is key for controlling volunteer corn.
That's good information. Thanks, yeah. Denny. Appreciate that.
The other thing to keep in mind is this stuff grows so thick, it may take a second application. We clean up the first, or spray what we can, get the bigger stuff, but it's growing out of an ear. A lot of the little stuff underneath won't get a lethal dose, will regrow. So anticipate in these heavy pressure areas, it may take a second application to get the volunteer corn cleaned up.
Here's a quick reference guide for you for SelectMax herbicide. This is a Bayer Plus Rewards qualifier, so just wanted to give this as one example of volunteer corn herbicide. So pause the video, use this as a reference if you need something to refer back to. Thank you for listening.